Hi again, this is James at Highland Outboards, and today we're going to look under the hood at the water cooling passages for an outboard motor. This is a Suzuki 4 horsepower DT4 outboard motor, and I've already released the power head, seven bolts that come underneath this lower cowling. I've removed those, a few various other connections just to make it easy. For example, this fuel tank, move that out of the way. And then I'm just gonna bring this power head up and tilt it over so we can have a good look. What you can see here, first of all, is the cylinder head with the head removed. That's the spark plug. The head mates to the cylinder with a gasket, and over here underneath are the water cooling passages for cooling water coming in and hot water going out. So I'm going to describe that so you can see exactly what happens. First of all, this is the water tube right here. The water pump down in the water near the propeller pumps water up through this copper tube and through this grommet. The cool water then travels and fills this passageway. Okay, when the power head is mated to the lower unit exhaust tube, that cooling water is in this area. Can you move the camera this way? Okay, that cooling water comes up into the cylinder through two holes, and you can see as I shine a light through this hole down in the cylinder head, you can see one hole and then the other hole. Okay, that's right here. Okay, that's the cooling water going into the cylinder head. It completely fills this area around the cylinder, becomes hot with the heat of the motor and the exhaust, and then it returns through this hot water passage right here. This is the hot water hole, and it corresponds with this isolated area in the power head. That then brings the hot water into this part of the exhaust tube, and here is the hole for the telltale, and you can see my light shining through there. The telltale water spray that comes out of your engine letting you know that you have water pressure is right here. But notice that your hot water coming out of the engine does not only go through that hole. If you don't see water coming out of your telltale, you might have a clogged nozzle, in which case the hot water can also go over this dam, through this passageway, and down through the exhaust tube. So hot water exiting the power head is going both through the telltale and through the exhaust tube. So when I put this back together, it's very important to have clean surfaces on both sides and use a new gasket. This gasket for the power head mating to the exhaust tube, and this gasket for the cylinder head. That's all for today. Thought I would help to explain and remove some of the mystery about what happens to the cooling water as it goes through your outboard motor. If you guys liked what you saw, like us, share us, subscribe to us, and we'll keep you updated on the latest with outboard repair. Thanks.